Hello everyone, myself Sonali Huddar from Department of Information Technology. Now, today we are going to continue the topic inheritance. In earlier lecture, we learned about inheritance. What is inheritance? Inheritance is nothing but creation of new class from existing class. Okay. In earlier class, we learned about the types of inheritance that are nothing but total five types are there: single inheritance, hierarchical inheritance, multi-level inheritance, hybrid inheritance and multiple inheritance. In this video, you are going to learn about the two types of inheritance, that is multi-level inheritance and hierarchical inheritance. So one by one, that topic we are going to cover up. So very first, that is nothing but multi-level inheritance. What is multi-level inheritance? Over here, from one class you are going to derive another class, and from that another class again you are going to derive the another class. That is nothing but multiple levels here we are going to create, and that is why it is known as multi-level inheritance. Here, just consider three classes are there: class A, class B and class C. Class A works as a parent class for class B, and now from class B you are going to derive another class, that is class C. So class B also works as a parent for your class C. So class B in this diagram works as a child for class A and parent for class C. That is nothing but our multi-level inheritance. Okay. Now just consider the program on this multi-level inheritance. Over here, we are going to create total three classes: class A, class B and class C. Class A, in this we are going to create one method, that is square method. Okay. Class A, void square int A. I am passing integer variable A to his, which is going to calculate square of that A. System.out.println A into A. In this way, I am calculating square in class A. Okay. Closing of my square method, closing of my class A. Now, I am creating another class, which is going to use extend keyword. As you know, extend keyword is used for creating inheritance. Okay, with the help of extend keyword, you are creating inheritance. So class B extends A. Okay, so class B is nothing but the child class of our class A. So class B extends A. In this class B, I am going to write one more method, that is nothing but cube method. Void cube int B. Okay, so for this cube method, I am passing integer variable B, via which I am going to calculate cube of that. So system.out.println B into B into B. So I am calculating cube over here. I am just closing cube method and I am just closing class B. Now, as per the diagram, what I am saying? Now class B I am going to create as a parent for class C. So how to create is same method. That is nothing but class C extends B. Okay, class C extends B. So C work as a child for parent class B. Now in this child class, I am just going to call one display method via which I am going to show the message hello. System.out.println hello. I am closing that display method. I am closing that class C. Now I am going to create a main class. In that class, I am writing main method. So class multi-level demo is there. In that I am creating public static void main string args. So main method is there. In that main method, I am creating object. Now, if you are concentrating on the diagram, class C is the child of class B and class B is the child of class A. So in last, as you are having class C, so class C will have all the properties of class A and class B. And that is why whenever you are going to create object, you just have to create object of that child class C only. So here I am creating object of C. C, S is equal to new C, which is my constructor. Now S is my object. So with the help of that object, I am just going to call the methods of all three classes: class A, class B and class C. S dot square of 2, S dot cube of 4, S dot display method. So when I am going to call this, just consider the output of this: Java C multi-level demo.java, Java multi-level demo. So first of all, so now we are going to execute this with help of Java multi-level demo. So first of all, we are getting output as 4, which is nothing but square method which is called from class A. Okay, as I am passing value 2, so I am getting square of 2 as 4. Now I am getting another output, that is 64. What is that? That is nothing but the method which is present in class B, cube method. As I am passing value over here as 4, I am getting cube of that 4, that is nothing but 64 over here. And the last one, that is nothing but I am getting as an output hello. This hello comes from class C, where I am having that display method. Okay, so from all the three methods that present in three different classes, I am going to access with the help of my inheritance concept. So this is nothing but multi-level inheritance. Now move to the next, that is nothing but hierarchical inheritance. Now in hierarchical inheritance, what happens? One parent class is there which is going to have more than one child class. One parent class and which is having more than one child class. So number of child classes are there which is having only one single base class, one can say. Okay, that is nothing but hierarchical inheritance. Now just consider the program on this hierarchical inheritance. Over here, I am just creating one class, class hierarchy demo. In that, I am just going to call one method void display, and in that I am printing message as hello. Okay, I am closing my display method, I am closing my class hierarchy demo. Now I am going to create child class of this class. So class A is a child class of hierarchical demo class. So class A extends hierarchical demo. Void sqr int a system.out.println a into a. I am just calculating square of this. Now along with that, I am just going to create another class, that is class B, which is again going to extend hierarchical demo only. Okay, so here I am creating two classes, class A and class B, which is going to extend hierarchical demo, that is nothing but the parent class. Only one single parent and two child classes are there. In this class B, I am just going to call cube method void cube int b, and I am just going to display that cube with the help of system.out.println b into b into b. Closing of my cube method, closing of my class B. Now I am going to write my main class, okay, where main method is there. So class hierarchical main demo, in that I am going to write my main method public static void main string args. Now over here I am creating object of both the classes to access the methods respectively. Okay, if you are considering this diagram, if here class B is the child of class A and class C is also the child of class A. So class B will have its own properties along with class A properties, and class C will have its own properties along with class A properties, which is the base class for that both the classes. But here class B and class C, both are the childs of class A and they are not going to share the properties among them. Okay, so just remember this thing, as both are the child of class A, they are not going to share any property among them. Okay, so now just concentrate on this. Here I am creating object of A class. A1 is equal to new A. Okay, and with the help of that A1, I am going to call the methods of A and B class. So A1.sqr of 2 and a1.display method. SQR, this method is present in my class A, and display method which is present in my hierarchical demo class, okay, which is my parent class. So parent class and child class, both the classes method I am going to access over here. Now I am going to create object for class B. Class B is having which method? Cube method. So I can access that cube method along with its parent method, that is nothing but display method. So b1 is equal to new b, b1.cube of 4 and b1.display method. So in this way I am just calling this both the methods. Okay, now with the help of this I cannot access A class method, that is square method, I cannot access with the help of B1 object, and cube method I cannot access with A1 object, okay, as both the childs cannot access each other's properties. Okay, so now when I am going to execute this Java C hierarchical main demo dot Java, then Java hierarchical main demo. So in this way I am getting the output as 4, which is the square of 2, and hello, which is the display method call, and next one, that is nothing but 64, which is from class B cube method, and hello from class hierarchical demo, that is parent class method display method. Okay, so this is nothing but hierarchical inheritance. Thank you.